Hello everyone, this is Wolf33. In this video, I will explain the Formula Plus, how to use it, where to get the research materials for the Formula Plus and upgrade them. So keep watching and don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you found that the video is helpful. Formula Plus is to grant its extra attributes and effects. This new feature allows you to add modifications to your equipment for even bigger power boosts. It takes a lot of work and a bit of luck to get a good modifications, but the end result is well worth it. In order to add modifications to your gear, you will first need to conduct research. Head over to your Formula Research Station, and you will note the Formula Plus option at the bottom. There are three types of formula you can make: clothing and this one for the armor, and also there is weapon and helmet. And you can only use one for each type, but you can increase your Formula Plus by buying the extra Formula Plus drawings from the weapon shop. And this will give you more than one modification for your gear. You can use this extra formula to have gathering, fighting, or any other survival modification. Each one will cost you 5k gold bars, so make sure to buy what you want only. As we said, there are three types of formula you can make: clothing, weapon, and helmet. Choose the one you want to conduct research on. Once there, you can add the required materials like reagent, crystal, components, and filament. Tap on the R&D button on the lower right to begin research. Each material grants a random stat to your formula. You can check out the possible stats on the right side after placing the material. After the random stats have been determined, you can still choose if you want to keep the old stat or if you like the new ones better. Keep in mind that even if you choose to keep the old stat, you still won't get the materials back. It's the same for the helmet and the weapon. So now, select your armor. Click on More, then Upgrade. Select Clothing Formula Plus and tap on Upgrade to apply it. As you see, I got swimming speed and damage caused by infected reduced. You get higher stats if the materials that used to make the Formula Plus are higher level. After that, go check your armor, scroll down, and you will find the new modifications. Now, let's try the weapon formula and see what we can get. So, select your reagent and crystal, then click on R&D. You can add film or components if you have some. Then, select your weapon, click the same, and upgrade it. I got these stats and I'm using it on Snow Type 95 because it's added more damage to the infected. As you see here, this Type 95 has 20.8% damage to the infected. With the Formula Plus, this damage will increase by 1.3%. Now, let's talk about some of research materials that use it to make the Formula Plus. First, we have a level 1 HB regens. When you use this material in Formula Plus research, there are a chance to get either crit immunity rate, explosion damage reduction, damage caused by infected or humanoid monster or wild animals reduced. So if you need one of these stats, try your luck and roll it in the research machine. And be aware, the higher the level of the materials, the higher stats you get. The next material is a level 1 speed crystal. These materials give either fire, reloading, slashing, movement, or swimming speed increase. The attack regens gives either jump or squat or height suppression, back damage and increase a crit chance. The accuracy crystals increases damage to the other players and infected, also increase damage to the humanoid monsters and animals. These are all the research materials that use it to make formula blasts with their higher levels. And you can see the stats that each one gives by viewing them in Gear Workstation. So make sure to make the sets that suits you, either for fighting or gathering or survival, and try to upgrade these materials to the high level as much as you can. It may be fun to go on a research rampage in hopes of getting the best possible stats for your formula, but make sure you don't use up all your materials. Once you have a formula, there's still the matter of adding it into your gear. Adding a formula modification to your gear requires you to use the same materials that were spent in creating the formula. That means if you run out of materials, you will have an awesome formula but no way to add it into your gear. So once you got a lot of level 1 research materials, all you have to do is upgrade them in order to get even better formulas. To upgrade a material, you will need to go to your gear workstation, tap on make weapons, then go to the upgrade tab. This is where you can upgrade all formula materials. Crafting higher level materials required a lot of resources. Upgrading to the next level were required 4 of the previous level plus additional items. For example, to get a level 2 HP regens, you will need 4 level 1 HP regens, 4 big irons, and 2 nylon cloth. To get a level 3 HP regens, you will need to multiply all those items by 4, then add 2 plastic, 2 steel, and 1 film fabric. Considering you will need at least one set of level 3 materials for researching, then another set for installing them on your gear. Formula Blast research can become a massive drain on your resources. Make sure you don't try to rush it by spending gold bars in the market. Instead, treat it as a long-term goal that you can achieve by taking things slowly and steady, stock up on materials, and craft higher levels once whenever possible. Also, as I said, you can scroll down and check the stats of each materials before making any formula or upgrade them. How we get the research materials? First, you can buy some of them from the weapon shop. This will cost you new dollars and the contribution points to get 2 level 1 random regens, 2 level 1 random crystals, and a level 1 random film each day. By exchanging your vault security points with some new dollars, you can get 2 level 1 random regens, 2 level 1 random crystals, 2 level 1 random films, and if you pay some fit credits, you can get a level 1 random component. Also, by using your nanoplastic, you can buy 2 level 2 random regens and 2 level 2 random crystals. In the next video, I will explain the vault and the nanoplastic. By using Vault Forest Stronghold points, you can buy 2 level 1 random regens and a level 1 random crystals each day. Also, you can use Sandcastle Stronghold points to buy 2 level 1 random regens and a level 1 random crystal. But in Snowhelland Stronghold, you can buy a level 1 random crystal and a level 1 random film, but you need to pay 200 gold bars to get the film. In Mouth Swamp Stronghold, you can buy a level 1 random crystal and a level 1 random fell. Also, you need to pay 200 gold bars to get this film each day. From Mount Snow Stronghold, you can buy a level 1 random film and a level 1 random component, but here You need some field credits to get this component. From Camp Drill's supplies chest, there's a chance to get two random agents and a random crystal or a random felt. From the membership daily chest, you can select either a level 1 random crystal or two level 1 random regent. From the mall, you can buy a random regents, random crystals, random films, and random components. Also, you can buy the level 4 research materials formula. This formula will make you able to upgrade your level 3 materials to level 4 and get higher modifications. Also, you can buy them from flea market and using training events points to get the level 4 research materials formula. The last one is from Trade City. You can buy the research materials from the other players. Also, you can buy the level 4 research materials formula from them. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to leave like and subscribe. If you have any question, just write it in the comment section. Also, don't forget to share this video with the other survivors. See you in the next video.